Hello everyone. So today we are going to discuss about the workflow concept in Oracle Identity Manager. I have received many queries from many of you guys that workflows are one of the most toughest topic in Oracle Identity Manager. So I have decided to make a video especially in order to sort out your all doubts and queries related to this particular topic. So before I will start the workflow topic, let me tell you something about the approval policy. Now in Oracle Identity Manager 11GR2, up to patch set 2, there was a concept of approval policy. But your environment or in your enterprise, if the Oracle Identity Manager has been upgraded to the patch set 3, then this word have been renamed as approval workflow. Now, what are the basic difference between approval policy and approval workflow is that in approval policy, we have basically two different, based on the request type, we are going to decide that which a workflow or which SOA composite is going to be triggered from Oracle Identity Manager. And there are basically two different kind of requests. That is, one was with the request based approval, and the other was operational level approval. Now basically request level approval is going to determine that, let's say this is the end user and he went to the catalog in OIM and request for a particular item which is available in the catalog for this particular user ABC. Now when he is going to raise a request for, let's say the item is cake, let's say this particular item is available in catalog as an entitlement. The name of the entitlement is cake. Now first approval will go to check whether this particular person have the privilege to raise a request for this particular entitlement or not. Now this validation is generally done from the manager. That manager will decide that this particular item is really required by this user or he is making any false request. So this is called as a request level approval. So basically in request level approval, the request or the cart item is getting validated from the manager itself. But in the operational level approval, it will go to the actual operational manager or the operational approver, and they are going to decide whether they need to approve or reject this request. So these are the two different terms which were generally used in approval policy in 11GR1, R2, up to patch set 2. But if I talk about the approval workflow in patch set 3, the patch set 3 still support approval policy if you have upgraded your environment from lower to upper. But Oracle is recommending all of us in order to migrate all the approval policy to approval workflow. Now, what is approval workflow? Now, in the approval workflow, all the approval or all the SOA composite are getting triggered based on the type of the operation the user is performed. For example, there are different types of operations like provision, revoke, assign, create, delete user, and all these different types of operations which are available in Oracle Identity Manager. Now approval workflow basically concentrated on these operations, that if a particular person is raising a request for provisioning a particular entitlement, then based on the operation type, the associated workflow is going to be triggered. Now this is the concept of approval policy and approval workflow in Oracle Identity Manager. Now, if I talk about the terminologies which are mainly used in Oracle Identity Manager in order to, now, if I talk about all the all the composite are stored in our sova, right? Now this is my OIM, this is my sova. All the composites are listed over here. Let's say beneficiary manager approver, operational manager approver, like this. Now how OIM is going to trigger, or how OIM is going to know that these are the approval policies, or these are the different type of composite which are available in SOA. So whenever a developer develops a new composite, a new workflow, he's going to deploy that composite in SOA. Now once he deployed the composite in SOA, he needs to register that composite with OIM. And if you are deploying all those things using Enterprise Manager console, then you no need to separate register this composite with OIM. The EM console will automatically register the things also. Now let's see how the communication happened between OIM and SOA. This is one of the most important topic, that how the communication, or how the data exchange, or how both different type of components are talking with each other, and at the end they are going to conclude that whether the request needs to be approved or request needs to be rejected, how all these things are following. Now before going to that, I just want to make you aware of few of the concepts of workflow. Now what are the all the different concepts? First thing is request. The request is nothing. Let's say if an end user is requesting for something from self-service console, he needs some item or he needs some access to a particular target system, he is raising the request for that particular item in Oracle Identity Manager. This is nothing but my request. Now requests are several types. For example, I am making a request for provisioning and entitlement, for provisioning an application instance, for provisioning a role, for deleting a user, like this. There are several different kinds of requests which an end user can make. Now talking about the second concept in Oracle Identity Manager, that is the approval. Approval. So approval is nothing but, let's say if I have raised a request for provisioning an application instance, then who are all the different parties who are going to approve my particular request? So all these things are decided using the composite. Now the third terminology is SOA composite. So basically SOA composite is nothing but it contains all the business logic in order to complete the task of approval. Now next thing, if I talk about the next term which is mainly used in workflow, that is partner link. Now what is partner link? Now this is my OIM, this is my SOA. Let's say there is a workflow called beneficiary manager approval. Now OIM will invoke this SOA composite, and at a particular instance of time while running, if this particular SOA composite need any input which is not available in SOA and he want that input from OIM, then we refer this connection as partner link. So basically partner link provide the composite some additional details about the request. Additional details about the request. Hope this is clear for all of you. Now coming to the next part, we have something called request web service. Now what is request web service? Request web service. Now request web service is nothing but, let's say this is my Oracle Identity Manager. Now this is my customer application. Now in OIM I have a entitlement in place which is giving the access to a particular application. To a particular application means where the customer wants the access. Now they can, this customer can send some web service call and invoke a request in my OIM. So basically request web service is nothing but a web service which have been exposed to the customer so that they can utilize this web service in order to raise a new request. Now coming to the next concept, that is request callback. Now what is request callback? Now let's say this is my OIM triggered the request and select the appropriate composite and send the request to SOA. Now once the composite ran and at the end the outcome is rejected or approved. Now this message or this decision we need to communicate to our Oracle Identity Manager. This communication we referred as request callback. This is nothing but request callback, which upon receiving the request callback, OIM will decide that whether request has been approved or rejected, and based on the outcome, OIM will either initiate the operation or OIM will reject the request. Now these are the major things or major terminology which is used in Oracle Identity Manager. Now let's talk about the complete architecture, the complete flow, how the complete flow is going. Now let's say this is my customer, this is my Oracle Identity Manager, and there are several access like entitlement 1, entitlement 2, like this. Now this person opened the self-service console. He has raised a request for provision entitlement 1. Now when he raised the request for provision entitlement 1, what OIM will do? The request engine, this request will getting submitted to OIM. Now request engine will decide that based on this operation, which composite needs to be invoked. Now let's see, based on this entitlement type, there is no composite, there is no workflow rule available in my Oracle Identity Manager. Then on that moment of time, the request engine will by default call the default approval policy. It will call the default composite. Now let's say it called the appropriate composite. Now once the composite is called, then the request engine will, up to this part is clear, I hope so. Now what the request engine will do? Request engine will invoke that particular composite in SOA. Let's say for this stage of workflow already deployed, workflow 1. Now once this will be invoked, obviously the request engine will also pass some additional data related with the request. Now we refer this data as request payload. These are nothing but all the data are passed in XML format. Now all these data come to my workflow. Now this is nothing but business process execution language. The workflow will start execution, start in executing mode. Now once the workflow will run, if workflow needs some additional data, it will, using the partner link, it will ask for some additional data from OIM. Like who is the approver for that particular entitlement and all these things. So these are the additional data. Using the partner link, the workflow can ask for these data from the OIM. Now, once all these things will be done, we have something called human task. Human task is a component which is defined inside SOA which will need a manual intervention. A manual intervention means here the business users are getting involved. In human task, we will decide that to whom we need to send the approval or whom approval we required in order to further proceed the execution. Now in human task, we are going to define that to whom this request is going to be sent means the approval for approval, and once the approval will be done, we will get the outcome either approve or reject. Now once we get the item either approve or reject outcome as, then using the request callback service, we are going to tell our OIM ki boss, all the things or all the approval has been done. Now this is the outcome which we get from the business user, and business user, this human task is responsible for notifying the business user and getting the outcome from him. Now how many days the task will expire, all these things we are going to configure in this human task. Now once this part will be over, OIM will understand whether the request has been approved or rejected, and based on this approval and rejection, OIM is going to perform the operation. So that's completely about workflow, the SOA, how OIM and SOA are going to interact with each other, and this is the complete architecture. So guys, I also want to give you a small information that I am also running my own training classes, and today I have scheduled a demo session on at 7:30 p.m. to 8:30 p.m. IST timings. If anyone is interested in order to see the demo session and want to join my course, he or she can either ping me in WhatsApp. The number is 9190 4688 1874, or he or she can send me an email at coalfieldexpress@gmail.com. So thanks for watching the video, and in the next video we are going to create a custom workflow, and I promise you that if you watch that video also, you are getting you are not going to forget that particular workflow concept will get easier for you. So thanks for watching it. Bye bye.